Hello and welcome to another Parts Factory installation tutorial video. Today we're going to be working on the Ford Focus. That is the year models between 1999 2005. We are going to be replacing the overflow bottle. It's a very, very straightforward job. All that's going to be required is a pair of pliers and a 10mm socket on a rattle gun or a wrench or anything of your choice. The new part and a little bit of patience. Now just before we get started, I did want to say that you should probably consider putting a drop sheet underneath the car, especially if you're working in a garage or somewhere where you don't want to destroy the ground. I'm working on the dirt today and this coolant system is full of water only, so I don't actually have to protect it from dropping on the floor, but you should certainly consider doing that. Now, if your car has been running any longer than 2 minutes, first steps is to make sure that the coolant system isn't pressurized or hot. What I've already done is about 5 minutes ago, I pulled the cap off and just stuck it to the side just to let all the hot gas escape from the bottle. You don't want to crack it and have it explode all over you and see it, you know, burns all your skin. Now, by the way, if you are looking for this part, just before we do continue on with the install video, we do sell them here at partsfactoryoz.com.au. I believe this part is $68.30 and it does include the overflow bottle lid. Very high quality part. I'll give you a look. And here it is here, guys. As you can see, there's your genuine bottle there on the left. Our new bottle is just a step above genuine Ford products, which is unbelievable to say, but like, just look at the quality of it. Look at the seals on the edges. Shouldn't have any dramas with this one. Oh, and Charlie's back again. There she is. What's she doing? All right, let's throw this bottle in. First steps first is we're going to be undoing this 10mm bolt just here. Very straightforward, straight at the left-hand front of the bottle. Now this bottle, other than that bolt, anything that actually holds it in is a slide bracket. So, as you can imagine, after we undo that 10mm bolt, we're going to be lifting that bottle out, undoing these three hose clamps. 1, 2, 3. I'm not sure if there's one underneath. I don't think there is. And then this overflow bottle will be out. There it is there. You don't want to drop this, but if you do, it's not the end of the world. See if you can almost just leave it there and use your two index and point finger just to pull it out like that. Stick it up the top here out of the way. Now you'll notice straight away that this bottle's become loose. Should now be able to put your finger in there, just pull up on that bottle. There it is there, it's off that mount. Right, you're gonna need some sort of pliers. I like to use the adjustable pliers. You can see here that you can actually expand. I'm not sure if I can do it with one hand, but you can actually expand the, no, I'm not gonna be able to. It will slide wider, and the reason why you want that option is so that you can get around the larger hose clamps easier instead of extending the pliers all the way out, not being able to reach. Okay, so it's now time to undo our hose clamps. So as I said, we're going to extend out our pliers, squeeze those clamps, bring them down the pipe. We're gonna do the same one with this. Just like that, bring them down the pipe. There you go there. Then you want to clamp down on the pipe itself, give it a bit of a twist. Now this will probably be pretty brittle under here. I'm gonna find out in a sec. Giving it that twist just like that, loosens it up a bit. Then at that point, because you've done that, these should just, there it is there, pull off like that. 1, 2. And kind of just leave them out to the side. Now extend your pliers even further, raise your bottle into the air, and we're going to get that last clamp there. You can see that just slides down the pipe, doing the same thing again. This time twist the bottle using your hand. Because we've done that, you should now just be able to wiggle that pipe off nice and gentle. There it is there. Right, so just here is where our bottle was sitting. And here's that little mount. Fairly straightforward to work it out. Alright, it's about time we put our bottle back in. Now, just before we continue, guys, if you do like this type, these types of videos, installation tutorials, please like and subscribe to our channel. It does help us massively, and it'll allow me to actually make more videos like this one, so everybody can start to start the DIY revolution in Australia, at least. All right, let's chuck this bottle back into the car. Right, guys, step one is to put that big bottom hose back onto the new overflow bottle. Should just squeeze on. Then bring your hose clamp back up. You want to squeeze it just as it's on, just as it's about to hop back onto the thick end of the bottle, and let go right where it was used to be. You can see the mark on the pipe. Then at this point, we can now slide the bottle back into its mouth just by placing it in and pushing it down. Then we can put our two pipes back on. We have our one pipe here, sliding it on nice and gently. Second pipe here, doing the same thing. Nice and flush. We can even put our pipes back in our mounts, like that. Drag your hose clamp back up using your pliers. You want to spread that hose clamp like that, using the two hands. Dragging the bottom of it with your left hand, unless you're left-handed, obviously the opposite way. There we go. Using that left finger to pull that hose clamp up over the top where it's thick. This one's a little bit more difficult. There we go there. You see the two hose clamps are nice and flush. Next step is to put our 10mm bolt back in where it came out of without dropping it. Done. And that's your overflow bottle reinstalled into the car. Right, so that looks a lot better. Sits very flush and it's a lot more reliable now. The overflow bottles is a very important part of this, of any car, as all of your radiator fluid does travel through it. If at any point you have any cracks in your bottle, you'll notice that the water will slowly seep out over time, causing your car to overheat, potentially causing catastrophic engine failure at any random time. Right, all done. Easy, wasn't it? Literally took 5 minutes, but still always important you do watch tutorials, because you never know with late model cars and even early model cars if there's any little tips or tricks necessary to make sure the job's done correctly the first time without destroying your new goods. You don't want to have to wait for them to come back in the mail all over again. But if you do have any recommendations, make sure you leave them down in the comment box below. Other than that, guys, that's just about all I have to say today. This is a very straightforward one. I really did this one just to keep up to my word, where we offer this tutorial free with any product here on PartsFactoryAustralia.com. Okay, guys, my name is Lucas Strabs, and I'll see you next time.